Time to play with some clay. Well, a slight update on my repair job on my silicone tool. It didn't hold, and I redid it this over this last weekend, and I got a feeling it's not going to work again. But what I'm going to do is always remind myself to work from this side instead of this side, because the beauty of silicone, nothing sticks to it, and probably that goes for Gorilla Glue. And I've taken my cap off so I won't be blocking the view of the camera, hopefully. What I'm going to do today is I want to give some structure to this shirt here behind the strap and everything, and I need to get my glasses on, my magnifiers, because my vision ain't good today. I have good days and bad days, and this is not a good day. Anyway, all right, let me see what I'm going to do here. Not quite sure what I'm going to do yet. I'll tell you one thing I got to do is get some of these damn tools off my board here. Belt. I'm getting a real late start today. It's just after 8 p.m. Mondays are always busy doing other things, and I wanted to get in here and do this. I'm probably not going to get this to the Foundry until Wednesday. That's okay. Make a wrinkle here. Clothing. I originally did him separate from her and her separate from him. And I made an instructional set of DVDs with both these figures being created. And if you want to check that out, a link to my 9 instructional DVDs is in the video description below. And you can take a look and maybe get those DVDs so that you can see how I created the figures. I'm going to increase the width of this pouch a little bit. Redo the brass tacks that I put into it, only because doing this powder horn. Created a problem. Now this is the tool that I repaired with the Gorilla glue. God, I said it at the right time, the right way that time. I don't know how much of this you'll be able to see because I'm putting some beads in between her and him, and her might just cover up what I'm doing. Let's see. Yeah. I think tomorrow I'm going to work a little bit on the baby's face and clean up her hair, which has been banged on when I worked on between these two figures here. I'll finish up texturing his shirt a little bit, and then I'll hit it with a little bit of lighter fluid to clean up the rough areas. So that's going to be it for today. I'm liking the way it's looking, and I think I got about another day's worth of work on it before I'm done. I don't want to rush getting it to the foundry. I want to get it to the foundry done, not partially done. All right. Good night, everybody. Time to get the ronson all out. Very delicate touch is the order of the day. No heavy-handed work here. You gotta realize this clay's been in place for at least 5 years, and I can still manipulate it. That's the beauty of plasticine. Clay. It's the fact that you can come and work on it years later. It's just like the day you started. I finally found the soft brush I was looking for. I know some of you know why I use the Ronsonol lighter fluid, but for those of you who are just watching for the first time one of my videos, I use it because it melts the clay a little bit. There's something in the plastiline clay that reacts to the Ronsonol, and I'm not certain what it is. I'm just thankful it is there to react. So those areas that need to be smoothed a little bit can be. Like his face. Okay, just about ready to do the photography of this piece, and that will end the video for today. Tomorrow, I take this to the foundry. Okay. Real wealth is finished. Now I can take some photographs of it. Good night, everybody.
Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right. See you next time.